Hi guys, in this exercise, we are maximizing the volume of a cylinder, a closed cylinder. We have a company that makes soft drink, and what they want to do is save a lot of money. So what they're doing is they've restricted each can to be produced with a surface area of 726 pi centimeters squared. Now with that limitation, they have to have the maximum volume. They want to put the most drink in that can. So our task, our mission, is to find the maximum we can put in that surface area per can. So the first thing we're going to do is write up the formulas for volume and surface area, and then we're going to look at how we can kind of reduce the variables. Then what we're going to do is the differential calculus, where we're going to differentiate first and differentiate a second time in order to find whether it's a maximum or a minimum. So let's go through those two stages. So let's start off with the formulas that we want to use, I guess. The first one is the volume, and the second one is surface area. So the first one I'm going to write up here is the volume. So the volume equals, because that's what we're looking for, our outcome is to maximize the volume. So volume equals pi r squared h. And for surface area, the formula is, and many of you already know this, equals 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h, and h being the height of the can or the cylinder. Remember, it is a closed can. So there's our surface area. They've got the top and the bottom, the pi r squared on the top, pi r squared on the bottom, and 2 pi r h is the part that's wrapped around there. So there's our two formulas. Now we want to maximize the volume, and as you can see up here with the volume formula right there, we have two variables. We have the r squared and we have the h, and you just cannot differentiate that. So what we have to do it is put that volume in a differentiating friendly format. In order to do that, we've got to use this formula right over here. So what do we do with this formula? Well, maybe we can replace that h by changing the subject in this one and making h the subject here. So in order to do that, we're just going to do a bit of rearranging and changing the subject. So let's go ahead and do that. Now remember, the surface area is 726 pi. So let me just go ahead and put that in. That's the surface area, and that equals, of course, 2 pi r squared plus 2 pi r h. Now our outcome is to make h the subject, so maybe I'll just put a little red around that, just to highlight it and emphasize it a bit so you can see what we're going for as the subject now. That's going to be the subject of our formula. So what's the best thing we can do here? Well, how about we make 2 pi r h the subject and take that 2 pi r squared over to this side. Let's move it over. So let's make that the subject. So that means we'll have 2 pi r h equals, let me put that red around it. That's what we want as the subject. 726 pi minus 2 pi r squared. Okay, so what can we do to further simplify this and make h the subject? Well, perhaps we can divide throughout by 2 pi. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to divide by 2 pi. That'll eliminate all the 2 pi's through there. So eliminating 2 pi from here leaves us with r h is equal to, well, divide that by 2 and by pi, that's going to give us 363, take away r squared. Okay, what are we going for again as the subject? I keep saying it, there's our h right there. So let's divide both sides by r, thus making h the subject. Okay, h equals 363 minus r squared, all over r, yes, and our h is the subject. So now that we have that, why don't we just go ahead now and replace the h up here. We're going to replace it from the volume right up here. There's the h. We're going to replace that with this guy over here. Just drag and drop it right in there. So let me just rewrite it out over here. So now we've got volume equaling pi r squared. And our h now is going to have a little square bracket like this. And we just go ahead and write that in. 363 minus r squared all over r, close bracket. There's our new formula. Now let's manipulate it a bit so it's still a little bit more simpler in order for us to differentiate in a moment when we get there. So what can we do? Well, I reckon we could cancel an r top and bottom here just to simplify it. So we get rid of r there, that goes in once, and r goes into r squared, goes in r times. So we cross them out, so we're left with the formula now of volume equals pi r outside of 363 minus r squared. Volume equals pi r, that's an r there, pi r minus r squared. Okay, all we need to do is expand that and we'll be ready to start differentiating. So let's expand this one. It's going to be 363 pi r. So let me just go up here. So volume equals 363 pi r, subtract pi r cubed. There we go. That's in a very differentiating friendly format. We have one variable and it's the r right there. Now we can differentiate it with regards or with respect to r. So we can get dvtr. So now that we've organized the formula, that was the first step. As you can see, let's start to differentiate now and come up with how we're going to get the maximum and the minimum. So we're going to about to do that now. So there's our volume, 363 pi r minus pi r cubed. Let's go ahead and find the first derivative. So let's call it dv with respect to r, dr, and that equals, well, that r disappears, so that's 363 pi. Take away, bring the 3 to the front, 3 pi r squared. Okay, now what do we need to make that equal in order to find a max or a min? Well, a stationary point means we make it equal 0, as you know. There's our 0. So what I'm going to do is, for this, we can bring the 3 pi r squared on that side, can't we? So 363 pi equals 3 pi r squared. There's other ways of doing it, but this way works pretty good. So let's cancel pi's from both sides. So I cancel pi from there and there. And that's going to give us 363 equals 3 r squared. Let's divide both sides by 3. So if I divide both sides by 3, that 363 will become 121 equals r squared. So all we have to do is get the square root of both sides. So therefore, r equals 11. Okay, we found the radius for us to have a max or a min, but we don't know yet if it's a max or a min. We're after a maximum, but let's confirm that with the second derivative. So let's go ahead and get the second derivative. So here we're going to get d squared v over dr squared, which is v double dash, same thing, prime prime. That's going to equal, as we differentiate over here, there's our first derivative, I differentiate that, that disappears. So 2 times 3 is 6, so that's a negative 6 pi r. There it is, our second derivative. If I take 11 and substitute it in here for the r, you're going to notice that the whole thing will become negative. Why? Because as you can see, we have a negative sign there. So that's going to go negative, and it's going to be less than 0. So that means we definitely have a maximum, what? A maximum volume. So that's what we got, maximum volume, because V is the subject there. So now that we have a maximum volume at R equals 11, obviously that's going to be centimeters. Let me just write that in. Centimeters, because we started off with centimeters squared there. That means all we have to do now is take that 11 and substitute it up over here so we can actually find what that volume is. So let's go ahead and do that. So we have over here. Let me just put a red line through here. Okay. All right. V equals pi r squared h. That's the volume. We know the radius is going to be 11. Let's start putting it in there. So V equals pi times 11 times height. Now, do we know what height is? No, we don't, so we can't put it straight in there. So a better place to put it in would be to put it straight into this V formula right there. That's going to make it work because we know the R. So let me just get rid of this because it doesn't work in there. And let's put in straight up here. So we're going to have a V equals 363 pi times 11. Let's put the 11 in there. Pi times 11. Take away pi r cubed. Subtract pi r 11 to the power of 3. Okay, let's further simplify this. 11 times 363 is going to give us a volume of, volume equals 11 times 363. On your calculator, will give you 3993 pi. Take away, let's put that minus sign there. Take away 11 cubed is 1331. So let's take away 1331 pi. So all we have to do now is subtract this from that, and that's going to give us the volume. So the volume is going to equal, and this is the maximum volume we can fit in a surface area of 726 pi centimeters, remember. Okay, here's the maximum volume that I can put in there is